Cabbage Patch y'all into this last section with my communications manager, Brandon Urry. How you doing, Brandon?
Doing well today.
Doing well.
Doing well.
Before we get into our one-on-one and give the world a little impact on what you're going to be doing for us for the year, let's do some recaps.
Absolutely.
All right. Starting with men's soccer. Men's soccer went down to Santa Monica on the road. We had Coach Vera Martinez last week. He said they like to start off on the road to build team camaraderie. They ended up taking the loss 2-0. You know, I told Coach I like to start at home, you know, to get that momentum from the home crowd to build on to the rest of the season. But, you know, Coach and them got their, you know, way of doing things. Let's see if that philosophy works out for them later in the season.
Mm-hmm.
You know, going on to women's soccer. The Renegades women's soccer team opened up the 2018 season with a home victory at Memorial Stadium, 6-1. In a half, that saw many players go down due to different injuries. The scoring started early when the Renegades' Michelle Vargas was assisted by Ryan Acosta and found the back of the net. Then they switched roles, and Vargas assisted Acosta for the next two goals to take the Renegade women's soccer team to the 6-1 victory. Great job by BC Women's Soccer. Moving on to women's golf, we have Allie Crawley shot a 154. Sydney Crawley shot a 164. Elizabeth Nakagawa shot a 214. And Brianne Bonkowski shot a 229. And Ramanda Lara shot a 260. That's it for our recaps, as really this week is starting the bulk of our season with regular season games. And that's why we have Manager of Communications, Brandon Urry. Welcome, Brandon. Let's get official.
Yeah. Great to be on today.
How you doing, man?
Doing good.
You know, no, it's beautiful to have you, man. You know, it's, you know, I was walked into this seat by the other sports information director. Being able to be here to transition the gap to you coming in is a beautiful blessing, man.
Yeah, no, it's great to have you. Everything you've been doing is good. I think everyone is really comfortable with you in the hot seat there and asking questions and tossing them things. I've heard nothing but good things that way. So,
well,
you know, can't complain. So, you know.
Well, Brandon, I'll tell you, man, they definitely threw me into the hot seat, man. I got a call in the middle of spring last year like, hey, kid, you want to do the Renegade Report? I'm like, how? When? Like, I mean.
Well, you know, when I was looking in the whole hiring process, I would watch these. You know, yeah. I mean, if you're ever going into a new job, you want to know everything you can about that place.
Nice.
And so going to the website, social media, just, you know, everything that Bakersfield College Athletics had, I would look at. So I did see a few.
Nice.
And I could say that you're doing good.
Well, I appreciate you, man. Well, hopefully they ain't ready to throw me out of here after Cabbage Packet and Bankhead bouncing in here. but let's talk season, Brandon. I know we open up on the road this week. We got Mount SAC College. They're ranked number 9 in the country. We're ranked number 14. You coming from Nebraska. Huge football history. You know, it's one of my favorite schools to watch. You know, I joked about Tommy Frazier and, you know, and Phillips and a lot of those guys I grew up watching as players. I'll tell you what, coming to California, this is as good as you're going to get coming from the Big Red, man.
Welcome. This is a big matchup this weekend, right? I mean, Mount SAC's always a good team. As an athletic department as a whole,
absolutely,
they've won the Nanica Cup a lot.
Yes.
So across the board, they compete at every level. Very high. So this, absolutely, this is going to be a good game. I mean, in fact, probably one of the toughest games for our football team this year.
Well, I, you know, being a Bakersfield guy, we always get the nagging from the Southern California guys, like we don't play a better brand of football up here. I always like starting with high level competition at the beginning because
it gives us
an opportunity to see where we are, right? You know, so let's talk team expectations for you. You know, I'm a historic Renegade guy. I always have high expectations. They'll never go away. You know, for you transitioning to this program, what are some of the things you're looking forward to as a media professional and just going over the year for the fall as a whole?
Yeah, absolutely. So, I mean, really highlighting the teams as we go through the season, winning always helps.
Absolutely, man.
Right, and anything that you do, whether you're at the college level or the professional level where it's more of a business and that's how you sell tickets, winning helps.
Absolutely. I tell people all the time, you know, they always say, man, why ain't the stadium packed like y'all was when y'all was playing? I'm like, well, first of all, we went 22-2 in 2 years, so that helps fill seats when you win the games, right?
That excitement builds in the community. And in a place like Bakersfield, I mean, for junior college football, we have incredible support. So if you want to look at it from the attendance side,
yes,
you know, where I was at in Nebraska, there's a little community college out there, Iowa Western Community College, that just started football in 2012, 2011, something like that. They're a brand new team.
Yeah.
And they won the national NJC2A championship within a year or two of being
amazing started.
And they did not get, like, attendance-wise, anything close to what we get. You know, getting about 4,000 fans a game here, you just don't see that anywhere in the country at this junior college level. So people come here and see the stadium. It's just unreal.
Absolutely. I mean, in high school, I packed our stadium. We played in front of 37,000.
See, you packed it.
I played on some great high school teams. You know, of course, I was a team captain, but I played on some phenomenal teams. You know, I definitely can't take credit for packing the stadium in high school, even though I call it the house that Kenny Cowell built. And I got the best record of any player that played on that stadium.
Trademark pending.
Trademark pending. But just the excitement that I have, I'm going to tell you straight up. Elisha Ortiz, Cam Roberson, Mr. Thomas, Carson Olivas, a few other new players that I haven't even seen play outside of the scrimmage. These players are some of the best players I ever seen, period.
Come through Bakersfield College.
Yeah, I'm talking period.
Period.
Yeah, I'm talking about nationwide output when they get the ball or on defense. We have some fantastic talent. So every year we have these expectations, but – if people think that we're going to drop off from the offensive level this year, they're in for a rude awakening. Because even though we had some sophomores move on, the key components to our offense are still here.
Yeah, I mean, there's some real weapons there, right? And I think weapons is a good word to use that is to describe these guys. They're quick. I haven't seen them in person, really. I mean, just in practice. But, you know, when you get to the game, it kind of flips a switch.
Absolutely.
And so I'm looking forward to seeing those guys compete. Yeah, and I mean, Division I talent, talk about that with all four of those guys that you mentioned.
Absolutely.
I mean, I could see all of them next year playing at that level.
Oh, yeah. Robert Roberson, because Robert is my older cousin. His son is Cameron Roberson. Cam, last year, could have transferred as a D1 transfer because he was a qualifier, and there were teams that wanted him.
Mm-hmm.
But Cam is wholeheartedly a Renegade faithful. So he told some of these smaller universities, like, no, I'm okay. I'm going to stick around and play with my guys because they need me.
Yeah.
And having leadership like that in a locker room is so rare when everybody's a me guy, right?
Yeah. Oh, that's huge. Yeah, and just bringing kids together. New year, new team. That's going to be, you know, a key foundation of that.
Absolutely. That's the most rewarding thing that I'm getting from this season is seeing guys like Cam. I mean, this dude had two punt returns for 90-plus yards last year and a kickoff return for 100. Players dream of having one of those their whole life.
Oh, for sure.
This dude, I mean, and that's not even talking about what he did on offense. He led the team in receptions with 44 catches, 500 yards. But he had three of the most fantastic plays of the decade on special teams. So it's not even talking about what he's going to do in the regular operation of the offense. Now let's talk about Mr. Ortiz. The guy between the tackles, I mean, like, you see him, he's probably 200 pounds soaking wet.
Sure.
He's not a huge running back.
Yeah.
But the way he runs in between tackles reminds you somewhat of LaDainian Tomlinson and guys that, you know, they had breakaway speed, but they like to stay in between the tackles and bounce when they needed to. So I can't wait for you to see these guys.
Oh, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, it'll be good. I think Elisha's going to light it up. Cam's going to light it up.
Absolutely.
It's going to be a good season.
Yeah, we got a few transfers as well. We got my cousin Shane Jones. I got two cousins in the backfield or on the offensive side of the ball that's going to do fantastic work. But just the overall impact of the team as a whole, our most special weapon last year was – Mr. Olivas, our punter, he was all conference. When our offense struggled based on inconsistency at the quarterback, he was the one consistent that kept us flipping the field. So I can't wait to see. How many times have you ever heard a sports reporter say, "Man, I can't wait to see this punter play"? That's how good.
And that might not necessarily be a good thing.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think in this case, I mean, he provides a lot of leadership on the team in and of itself. Aside from being a good player, you can see that he carries himself well, that the other guys like him. He's well liked in locker room. And that's
leadership.
Not normal for kickers and punters.
Yes. Yeah.
I was a kicker punter in college myself, so, you know, I kind of watch him and kind of see how he is. and he doesn't like sit over there by himself. He's with the guys.
Absolutely.
He's part of the team.
Yes, he's, you know what? And you just gave me another history lesson. I didn't know you were a kicker punter. I thought you were
back
just
there
a communi-
in the closet. You
I just
know?
Thought you were a communication specialist. You my football guy. You give me a hug, man.
Get over here.
Shoot, y'all just slid Brandon in here and just told me he's communication. He's gridiron gang, too.
You got it.
Well, hey.
You got it. Like, I'm excited for Carson because of that, though, because when he went down to Chris Saylor, his camp, and got ranked
nice.
in his top 12, Chris Saylor is one of the better kicking coaches in the country. And the guys that were in that, I was not in that. I wish I was. Gotcha. I might have played in the league if I was, because a lot of the guys that were the top 12 in the year that I went through,
wow.
they were all playing in the league. Some of them still are. So to get that, you know, level of you
Man.
Know, top 12 with Chris Saylor's kicking, that's a good sign. It doesn't mean that you're going to have an NFL contract, but, I mean, that means you have the talent.
You got the right tutelage, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I'll tell you this, Brandon. I just got goosebumps thinking about Carson Olivas transitioning into the next level. Shoot.
Yeah.
Hey, you're on your way. You heard it here first.
He's going to get there, yeah.
Well, you know, the fun thing about Olivas, I was chatting with his mom on Instagram. You know, she's my Instagram friend. And, you know, just talking about how we're all excited for this time of the year. You know, Bakersfield sometimes, you know, with the weather, it can be so hot. You know, we get gloomy. You know, welcome to the heat. You know,
oh, I love 110
degrees.
I
know
great.
You're coming from some snow and some cold.
I left my ice picks and my shovels in Nebraska. You better believe it.
Yeah, you can get your windshield cleaned off. It's just a little dusty now. But this is football town, football city, football time.
It is. Great place.
Brandon, I'm excited to have you, man. I can't wait to see the look on your face when Big Red takes the field. So we'll be in the booth. We're going to head up early, right?
Yeah, we're going to be there on Saturday.
Where are we at? Give them the logistics.
Yeah, absolutely. So at Mount SAC, their stadium's under construction. So Covina District Field. And if you go to our website and the schedule, you can see that. It's about 5-10 minutes from Mount SAC's campus.
Gotcha.
So we're kicking at 6, but we're going live at 5:30. You and Vance are going to be going live at 5:30, but it's going to be a good game.
Gotcha.
Good way to start the season down there. And we're going to have, if anyone's interested, we have our Rooter bus, which if you don't want to drive down there, make the 3-hour drive in a car sitting in traffic yourself or with a friend, I guess, but you can pay $25 and ride the Rooter bus down there with our cheerleaders and get there and then come home.
Nice.
On that same way. So just if you want to do that, call our athletics office or go to our website and see the release on that to get information on how to do that.
You know what I think we should do, Brandon?
What's that?
Although I love to drive myself, I think we should go live on the Rooter bus one day on the way to the game.
Yeah, that's a good idea. We should try that.
We should take the bus.
Get a little bit of energy from those fans,
energy,
right?
Do some
it's
Facebook
in the name,
live.
Rooter, right? We'll see. Yeah.
Hey, Coach Taylor, we need an extra seat on the Rooter bus a few weeks. But hey, this has been the Renegade Report. I got my manager of communications, Brandon Urry. He comes from Big Red, Nebraska. Now he at the Big Red BC, the Mecca.
Go Gades.
The house that Kenny Cal built, the palace on Panorama. This has been the Renegade Report. We want to thank all of our sponsors, and we'll see you next week. Great job.